In this guided meditation, we're going to be thinking about the stars. So just take a minute to settle into yourself. Try and sit up with a straight back or lay down flat on your back. And take a moment to notice your breathing and to slow it down. Breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. And just feel where you are in your mind and body. And if at any point during the guided meditation your mind wanders, that's okay. Bring it back to your breath and focus on that. But if you want to follow me on our journey to the stars, then picture yourself laying down on a comfy chair in a garden. In the middle of summer, and it's late at night. The skies are clear, as far as the eye can see. The summertime in the countryside is the best time to spot stars. If there's little light pollution, you can see many constellations. You might see satellites travelling across the sky. And if you're lucky, you may see a shooting star. So feel yourself laying in the warm summer heat, looking up at the stars above you. As you look at them, you notice how different they all look. Some are really bright. Some are quite faint. Some look much bigger than others. Some have a colour to them. You may even know the names of some of the constellations. Perhaps you can pick out Orion's belt. Or maybe you can see Cassiopeia. If you were in England, you might see a constellation called the Plough. And if you were in America, you would call that constellation the Big Dipper. Isn't it funny how in two different countries people can see the same thing in the sky? We may give it a different name, but we're seeing the same constellation. I think about this often when I think about my family and friends in other countries to me. We may not be able to see each other, but when we look up at the night time, we can often see the same stars. We don't always see the same stars at the same time of year. If you travel to the southern hemisphere, down to Australia or New Zealand, you may see different stars and different constellations to what we would be seeing here in America at the same time. But generally speaking, when we look to the skies, we know that our friends, family and loved ones can also look to the skies and see the same stars we do. Some people like to make a wish upon a shooting star. Others just enjoy to see them and know or feel that they are lucky having seen one. I like to count satellites with my family in the summer and have little competitions as to who can count the most. My nephew tends to win. But it doesn't really matter who wins. What matters is that we can see the stars together, even when we're not together. And at this time, there's probably a lot of people in your life that you aren't together with right now. And I'm sure that you miss them. But maybe you can look up to the stars one night and talk to them the next day and see if they saw the same stars that you did. But for now, it's time for us to come back from our starscape, back to the room where we are, and take a few deep breaths and gently blink our eyes open. I hope you enjoy this meditation, and I'll speak to you all again soon.